Okay, everyone, so I know it's been a little bit since I've posted my last O-Scale Trains video, and I apologize for that, but unfortunately, college has just been very, very, very busy for me in the last little bit. We just finished up midterm, so I'm finally getting around to get a small little break here so I can shoot some train videos here for you, but I just wanted to give you an update. I just have got these three freight cars in. Two of them are Rail King and one is a Premier by MTH. So I wanted to go ahead and give these a good unboxing and let you all see what I came up with here and give them a quick run around the layout here. So we'll go ahead and get into this. But we'll start with this first Rail King freight car here. And as you can see, it is a, hopefully that's focusing where you can see it there, but it is a Rail King TTX 50-foot modern boxcar. And I have not seen these yet, so this is gonna be my first reaction as well. So, let's go ahead and get it out of the box. And that looks really, really good. You can see there, it's a really sharp looking car. Of course, the doors do open on both sides. It does have legible writing and codes on the side. Here's the other side. Yeah, that looks really good though. Oh, the couplers are really nice too. But yeah, I bought this second hand off of eBay, but it appears that the quality is either new or never been run. I'm not sure. It was listed as used, but they seem like they're in really good shape. Anyway, that was the TTX boxcar, but let's move on here to the next one here. And before I open this, I want to show you. You see, this one is a Rail King Norfolk Southern center I-beam flat car, and then you can see the model number there if you're interested in that. But I've always liked these modern freight cars, but unfortunately, maybe it's just me, but I never have any luck finding really any good deals on modern O-scale freight cars. But hopefully that's not the case for everyone else. But anyway, I'll pull this one out here. Out of the plastic here. Move that out of the way. Oh yeah, this one's sharp too. As you can see, Norfolk Southern. And there's each end of the car. Whoop. And as you can see, the loads do come out like that, so you can have the center I-beam showing on the freight car if you so desire to do have that. I'll take the rest of these out here so you can see what it looks like all the way through. But there's the next car there. That's another great looking car. Let me get the loads out of the way here. And last but definitely not least, we have this Premier Line freight car. And if you can see here at the end, it is a Union Pacific center I-beam flat car. And this one has a log load in it. So let's go ahead and get this one out of the box too. And I was surprised. I didn't realize just how big this car was gonna be. So, get it out of the wrapping here, so you can take a better look at it. Wow, this thing is massive. Box it out of the way. You'll have to ignore the background here on the workbench. I've been working on my MTH Proto 1 Pennsylvania K4, so it's been having a few little issues there, so I've been working on that. But If you'd like to see that too, I can also make a video on that engine too if you would like. Just let me know down in the comments below. But anyway, back to this freight car. I know I have to get it into the frame here because it is so big. But anyway, this is a fantastic looking car. And here in just a second, I'll there's the underside of the car. A lot of extra details that you'll find on the Premier lines. And like the other one, the loads do come out on this one. Oops. And like I said, I apologize for the lack of videos, but unfortunately school is just really busy right now. So hopefully, and this probably won't be the most professional video that you've ever watched, but hopefully it's enjoyable nonetheless. But there you can see there's that Union Pacific center I-beam car. Looks absolutely fantastic. But anyway, that's enough of the unboxing, but let's get to the real part of what you're wanting to see, and we'll go ahead and get these put on the track and get them right around the little temporary layout.